Hey everyone, it's David Ellis from Halo Waypoint. I'm here with Chris Jackson from Acme, and we're here at San Diego Comic-Con. What are we checking out today, Chris?
Looking at every year at Comic-Con, we always look to have new Halo art, and this year is no exception. This one is called Let's Rock. It's an exclusive to Comic-Con. It's already selling very well. There's only 100 pieces in the edition. And the other one by Eddie is called Glasslands, and it's a piece he did for the cover of an upcoming Halo novel that'll kind of bridge the gap between Halo 3 and Halo 4. You know, I think it's just like it is with most anything like that people are drawn to. It's strong characters. It's a great game. And the more they play it, the more they like the characters and the environments and the worlds and even the artists. You know, like we said, we've done so many prints now. People know these artists that do this work, which is great.
And I'm here with Andrew Sparks from Mega Bloks. What are we showing off today?
Well, we were just showing a couple of things here, specifically the new Falcon, which is going to be in stores very, very soon. But to get everything spot on and correct, there's always new tooling that's involved. You look at the Falcon as an example, and I guess construction fans out there will love this. These are all of the new parts which are actually in the Falcon. So this is all new tooling that was not sort of within our tool bank to start with. And this is all new stuff which not only gives us a great-looking Falcon, but also offers a lot of opportunity to build other things.
So when everything's all said and done, you end up with this bad boy right here.
That's it, yeah. So that's the Falcon that's sort of hitting stores within the next couple of weeks. Fully sort of functional with the rotor blades up here. Sort of true to game if you want. Also got an opening cockpit with a little ODST is snuck in there, but actually comes with a real pilot.
And of course we're here at Comic-Con, but just around the corner, Halo Fest is marching on. We're marching on, I think we're 34. By the time you see this, be less than that. We're almost around the corner. What does Mega Bloks have planned for Seattle?
Oh, we got a lot of great stuff coming. We're counting the days. There's a lot of great events that are happening. There's a Guilty Spark that we built, sort of a full size. It'll be a Guess the Number of Bloks competition. A lot of really kind of cool prizes that we're giving away there. And then for the first 5,000 people that attend Halo Fest, we're doing a very special giveaway, which is a certain black vehicle from a PC-based game that people, the hardcore fans, will be familiar with. But very excited about it. It's a very special giveaway. Like I say, first 5,000 people will get one for free, and it comes with a couple of really cool figures we've never done before.
And we're rolling on over to the Halo Minimates booth. I'm here with Zach Oat. What are we showing off today?
Today we're showing off the anniversary assortment of Halo figures to tie into the 10th anniversary. So we've got the original Master Chief here with his little Cortana. And here's your little Cortana, which you can buy. And she comes with her card for display. And we've got a couple more figures, as well as a full assortment of classic Halo characters based on the original game. There's a lot of different characters coming out in that assortment, and we're also doing stuff for Reach as well. The Reach line is still continuing. We're doing a box set, two box sets actually, of Warthogs with the six members of Noble Team. A full assortment of Halo Reach figures comes out in August, just in the next few weeks. So you'll be able to get eight different characters at Toys R Us and another box set at the specialty market and at comic shops.
Okay, so a little secret. The guy in the blue is about to propose to the girl in the yellow suit back there, and she doesn't know about it, so hopefully she'll say yes, or this is going to be majorly embarrassing for him.
I saw a wedding engagement go down. Congratulations, first off. I'm here with Robert from NKOK, and we're going to show off a couple products that we're showing off here at the show floor. Some prototype products that aren't in stores yet, won't be for quite some time, but what are you guys showing off here at the show?
The Halo Falcon, which is actually going to be available in stores this August, and it's going to just knock your socks off, just the way that it looks. Very similar to the game, very iconic.
So this is a prototype right here. So if I was to drop this and break it, how much would I owe you guys? I'm going to put it down before...
Three quarters of your paycheck, if that, maybe, yeah, at least.
So that's in your hands now. Yeah. So it was good when I handed it to you.
Wow, it's the big San Diego Con. Right, so we've got lots of people coming here. We're going to show them a bunch of cool stuff, but really the big thing that you and I are excited about is the 10th anniversary of Halo. We're able to now go through the three games and show the evolution of what he's looked like, not only in the game, but in the way that his costume has looked like. So we've got the Mark V, the Mark VI, and then the Battle Damage Mark VI one. So we've got the Brute Chieftain. The Brute Chieftain has got then his big Mondo weapon.
Have you had any chance to look at any of the Halo 4 stuff and start your Halo 4 line?
Let me just say, for jealous reasons, anybody listening, yes, I have. So as you might imagine, as a toy maker, I get to see some of the curtain pulled back long before any of you guys do. So yes, I'm super excited because we actually get to make toys. I go, wow, not repetition again. The looks are going to be modified, weapons, ships, all the things that you expect. And I go, this thing's going to go for another 10 more years.